Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant, and welcome back to the channel. It has been one heck of a week on FC24 with prices rising, fodder, these Trailblazer cards going up, some prices not moving too much, content's been quiet, we didn't get evolutions yesterday, and we head into a big Thursday today of Rivals Rewards. What do we need to be buying? What am I buying today? That's what I want to talk about in the video, because this is the end of the week where we start to see with Rivals Rewards paying out, we have marquee matchups, and of course, the start of the weekend league tomorrow, we start to see the market move really well. So I want to talk about how we can potentially make some coins in a market that is very high. A lot of prices have gone up in a lot of different areas. We're going to try to invest and make some coins today into tomorrow. We're talking about that a lot today. If you're excited for it, drop a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new. First of all, we have to discuss the situation. We got excited for evolutions yesterday, and EA Sports did not reciprocate that with content. Unfortunately, nothing yesterday in evolutions. And I'm starting to get frustrated because what in the world is going on? EA, you literally promised us in the pitch notes that we were going to be getting an evolution every single week. We didn't get one like the second week of the game. It looks like we're not getting one this week unless they drop something like today or tomorrow. It's just confusing because literally in the pitch notes, it says weekly evolution. So I don't know, guys. We were excited for that. But again, that's how content goes, you guys. Like, it's EA's content. We try to predict it as much as we can. So a lot of times we get it spot on. And other times, since it, again, is all controlled by EA, We still, at the end of the day, do not 100% know. So, unfortunately, we didn't get any EVOs yesterday. But with the content that we did get, we actually got a good SBC. But it's not one that's really getting a lot of people excited. That is a goalkeeper SBC for Kevin Trapp. The best part about this is it's cheap. That's the best part. 83 rated squad, one team of the week. Basically free because 83s are like discard price. And I'm sure a lot of you, like myself, have a lot of them in the club. And we've had the team of the week SBC now for the last week to put those in our club as well. So that one's basically free. It actually did move a few prices on the market yesterday. I had some of those Gutsa Road to the Final cards that I had invested in last week, and those actually ended up selling. I had those listed for Lazies because he was about 23,000 coins. That SBC came out, and even the leak for that SBC came out. He went all the way up to about 27,000 coins. He's about 26K right now. A lot of people did trap. It didn't crash goalkeeper prices or really move them too much at all, but a lot of people did that SBC because it is basically free fodder if you have those 83s in your club that you can throw away into that one for free. So a lot of Bundesliga hype right now. Gutsa is up because of that SBC. Hinkape, Grimaldo are other cards that are up because of that SBC that was dropped. And also at the same time, it almost looks like EA is potentially pushing some Bundesliga because we have a leak for an objective that's coming this Friday, and that would be Palacios, a Leverkusen player. So that really made Hinkape and Grimaldo go up a lot. If you invested in Grimaldo or Hinkape at really low prices, I think you're okay to hold for now. But that Palacios card, it could be really good. We'll talk about it more in tomorrow's video. Might be the type of investment that you would want to sell in the hype just to be safe, because those cards, like Hinkape is 80K. He was 45,000 coins last week. Grimaldo is up about 10,000 coins a card. They're up a lot. So we'll talk a little bit about that more so in tomorrow's video related to the content drop that is coming tomorrow and Friday for Trailblazers Team 2. We also had a new pack SBC yesterday, but it was untradeable, guys. We had, you know, it's nice to have these, but I think we really want these tradable because we need fodder to keep going down, because a lot of us have sold our investments in that, and we're looking to actually do some SBCs. I'm 5 of 6 away on Sun, and that's where we're going to start to talk about the market today in relation to what's going to move on the market with Rivals Rewards. Let's get into the conversation, guys, because there is a lot to talk about. Of course, Thursdays are big for Rivals Rewards. Thursdays in the past couple of weeks have also meant big rises on the market, and that's what we expect today. Now, yesterday, when we're talking about fodder, we have to preface it with this. As expected, fodder did drop. Prices are down from the peaks that we saw yesterday before the content drop, because with the brand new team of the week, we had 150K packs in the store. Now, with this team of the week and how mid it looks, I don't know how many people are actually going and buying packs from the store to try to pack this team of the week. I know there's a great promo card, set of promo cards in packs with Trailblazers, a 5 million coin Mbappe that, yeah, I'm sure some people are chasing, and it's still the early game. So There's probably people that were opening packs yesterday, and there were, because we saw fodder prices drop, which we're going to look at here in a second. But still, this team of the week is not very good. It's like, look at the entire team. There's so many of these that are already at 11,000 coins or 10K, literally discard. Now, there are a couple nice ones in here. Otamendi, usable. Arsonist, great card. Look at all the different playstyles that he has, by the way. 7 different playstyles. Links to Di Maria, which were tough to come by before. David Neres is still somehow extinct. Don't understand why he's extinct when we have 2 new Benfica cards. Like, this Arsonist, like, that's a really good-looking card for a budget card. Anyway, the rest of the team of the week does not look very good. But because of the packs in the store that were opened, fodder has dropped. Take a look at 87. Some of the biggest drops in price yesterday happened on the 87 market, from 18 to 19,000 coins. These cards went down to 15K. Big drops there. The 89 rated price ranges actually got updated, guys. I'm surprised that EA updated these, but they didn't update that David Neres that we mentioned. He's still extinct at 60K, or about extinct. Crazy. But these cards that were extinct at 37,000 coins, they had a spike up in price right away, and then everybody who invested started listing them down, down, down. They're now back at about 40,000 coins for an 89 rated card. And that's important. We're going to talk about fodder in relation to today's Rivals rewards. Also, 90s were 60K. They're now down. They were 55. I think people are starting to buy up some of this fodder, which I actually like as an investment for today. A quick flip, really. Not as much of an investment for a hold, but we'll talk about that here in just a little bit as well. But fodder prices are down, right? 84s, 5s, 6s, 7s. Everything is down a little bit from that supply. That is what we saw yesterday. Now, golds on the rest of the market started to drop a little bit as well. As I'm taking a look here around the gold market, except for stuff that's going to be going out of packs, some slight drops. Militao is actually just 135. He's back up a little bit. I think Saliba is down just a little. It's not like big drops, just a couple cards here or there. We're just down a little bit. Rudiger's 59K. I think he started the day yesterday at like 61. So just, you know, he was 57 even. So some small drops there. That's kind of the market that we are currently in. Now, with Rivals rewards today, what are we looking at for a potential buy? That's the question. What is going to go up today? Because in previous weeks, a lot of those meta type cards have been stuff that's going up as people are going and buying teams. Now, I do think there is potential for cards like a Militao to go up today. He's already gone up in price. He was 130s. He's now 140. I think there is potential for this to go up a little bit further because people are going to be doing SBCs today. I think that's one of the biggest excitements about rewards today. At least it is for me. I'm excited to get rewards so that I get freaking packs so that I can maybe pack some 84s, 85s, and 86s so that I can go and do the SBCs that I'm trying to finish, because I feel like a lot of us right now need the fodder. I'm taking untradeable rewards for sure so I can get more packs and potentially get fodder to finish Sun, to finish Rodrigo, to finish Blanc. There are still so many SBCs right now that people are trying to finish on this game, especially for player SBCs like those ones we just mentioned. Declan Rice as well. A ton of SBCs that people are looking to be finishing today. That's why I think for flipping and for investing around Rivals rewards today, if you're going to be on the market, I think fodder might be one of the best places to be putting your coins. And where would I be putting my coins? Into the higher rated guys. Because think about it. What are you going to be packing today from Rivals rewards? Maybe 84s, 85s, if you get lucky, an 86 or two, maybe a walkout. And that might just give you enough fodder to finish off an SBC. Maybe you took tradable rewards, you get a little bit of coins, then you can go out and buy an 88, 89, or a 90 rated card, which, yes, is still up in price, but compared to where it was yesterday, instead of being 60K for a 90, let's say at Rivals, it's 55 for a Harry Kane. With rewards, people just go out and they buy fodder cards, right? I think that's going to happen today, guys, which is why I actually went in on some 89s. I specifically bought a Harry Kane and a couple of Ter Stegens. Ter Stegen is a card that I bought. I know that we had the trap SBC. I realize that, guys, but he's an 89 rated card that moves usually a bit better than some of the other ones. I didn't want to buy any of the 89s that just had price range updates. Rodri especially, like, a lot of people were investing in this card. They were listing it down. And as you take a look at his price right now, even as an 89 rated card, a lot of these are ones that people have invested in and they're not using, right? These are cards that aren't first owner pack pulled fresh. This is stuff that was sniped at 37K or bought before that, and then now people are trying to sell. I was trying to find an 89 rated like Ter Stegen or Alex Morgan that's a bit more rare that could rise up as the prices of 89s rise today. I also like 87s. I like 87s because they're, yes, 15,000 coins, which is a drop in price. I could see these going from like 15,000 coins where they are right now, or some of them rising slightly. I could see them rising to about 17,000 coins before we get to the content drop today. So if you're on the market at Rivals, what I would do is bid snipe on the high rated fodder, because this is going to put people into an SBC completion frenzy today. After they get rewards, they're going to get fodder, they're going to get coins, they're going to go out and do SBCs. I mean, I am going to want to do that, right? I might even use some of the fodder that I bought to go and finish the Hyunmin Sun SBC, which I have only one more segment for. Now, here is the scenario with fodder today. We have two windows for all of our buys for this rewards period today. First of all, window number one is what we're talking about right now at Rivals. You want to buy these cards during the Rivals supply. If you're awake for it, I think it's 8 a.m. UK time, or in the next hour on bid after that, because that is going to be the start of when prices start to rise. Actually, let me take you into Ter Stegen's graph from last week. This is just Ter Stegen, who I bought, right? This is how the graphs work on Thursdays normally. Prices are low. You see here, like right now, when I'm recording this video, we're right here. We're in the early morning hours of Thursday, today, October 18th. You might see a bit of a dip, right, as the rewards are actually released, but then what happens after that? This is Ter Stegen last week without as much SBCs and just more so of a meta demand. He went from 29,000 coins up to 33K. That's approximately like 2.5. He went up like 4,000 coins. So that's like 2.5K of profit per card. That's not a bad return on your investment for literally, what, 5 hours of time? And you're selling these cards before the content drop today, guys, because what do we get every single Thursday that brings supply to the market? Marquee matchups. That's window number one today, is buying cards around Rivals that we can then go and sell before marquee matchups, because once marquee matchups comes out, we're going to be getting even more supply as people will do this SBC. It'll supply the market on golds, and that'll create potential for window number two. So other cards that you could potentially be looking to buy today during this Rivals rewards time frame, you could, guys, be looking at some other meta golds, like we just talked about Militao. Think about Rodrigo is one of the most hyped SBCs right now. Rudiger could be a card that you look at. Ferland Mendy. These are cards that we watched during the weekend rise up a lot in price. I mean, even Ferland Mendy, people are starting to buy, guys. He was 94K. He's going up now to 99. With these rises before Rivals rewards, if you see them drop again at Rivals rewards and go lower from a price that was already up, that's a really good sign that that card could potentially continue to rise. And also, cards that did really well on Monday, like we shouted Tomori on Monday, right? We bought Tomori's at 59K literally on Monday, and he went all the way up to 70K. This rise, remember that? The same thing, maybe not as drastic, but a similar type of move on some of those same cards could happen again. And also, don't forget about the really, I would say like the lower tier, like cards that are maybe 2,000 to 3,000 to 4,000 coins. There's still cards in that range that are from big clubs like Llorente, 6,000 coins. That could be a card that still ends up moving a bit today on the market. Maybe Frimpong for some of the leaks that we have. Nuno Mendes, Colomani. These are cards that are still moving even though they're very, very cheap. I mean, take a look at Colomani on Monday, right? He went from 4,400 all the way to 5,100. So if he's down at like 4K on bid during Rivals Rewards, like that's a card you could buy as well on a lower budget. So I like that part of the market today after Rivals Rewards. Now, also during this time frame, a lot of people are going to ask, Nate, what about Trailblazers? What about Trailblazers? These guys are going out of packs. They basically seem impossible to pack. And it's given us, you know, the last 2 weeks of Road to the Knockouts have given us a really good opportunity to invest in cards before they go out of packs for a potential rise later on. I think there's potential to invest in these Trailblazers from Team One, guys. I really, really do. And I think with the way the market feels right now, it's going to have to be today or early tomorrow and Friday when we look to buy these cards. But I think we're going to have two windows of opportunity to buy these cards today if we want to make an investment. Now, I want to talk about this and also just share some market knowledge, because we're still really early on in the year. This is a trend that we saw in the past year on FIFA 23. Promo teams, when they're in packs, they're either cheapest at 1 or 2 points during the week. There's kind of two different ways that this goes most often before they go out of packs. The first one is promo cards. This is an example from last year. Promo cards are usually their cheapest on the Thursday or the Friday, right before they go out of packs, right? This Rule Breakers PK last year was 230K. He rose out of packs all the way to 300,000 coins in the next week after that, right? Very similar to rises to what we've seen already this year on some of the Road to the Knockouts. Dodo, RTTK, a lot of those cards from Team 1 were their cheapest on Thursday and Friday. He went from 53K in the next week, rose up to 80,000 coins, of course, still rising. Now, where we are at right now with this Trailblazers Team 1 is the second one of those scenarios, which we did see often last year as well, on weeks where it was a bit quieter, or especially where there was a lot of saved up packs for the Friday promo, which there was a ton of saved up packs this past weekend for Trailblazers Team 1, because we saw the team, it looked insane. If you remember this Road to the World Cup, or is that what this is called? Road to the World Cup promo last year. This happened during Black Friday. Ton of saved up packs during that weekend. These cards were their cheapest on Sunday and Monday before they went up out of packs. You see, Timo Werner was 62K. That was his lowest point before. By the end of the week, he went to 77,000 coins and was above the 60K range, in the 70K ranges for weeks and beyond. That's kind of how we are with this team right now. Ruben Dias is 103,000 coins. He was 97K on Sunday and Monday. This promo team has risen in price. Some of them very drastic amounts. I mean, take a look at Hansen. Hansen was 1.7 mil on Saturday, Sunday. She's now 2.1, right? We've had some pretty crazy rises on these Trailblazers cards. And guys, when you look to invest in a promo team as well, there's a lot of things you could look for. Even though the cheapest point technically was on like Sunday, right? Today is a day of supply where if you get prices that are close to that cheapest point, and we still believe that those cards could still rise out of packs, which barring some insane content, a lot of these cards should rise out of packs. To be honest, it's been a week of a promo team that's very tough to pack. Compare this team in regards to last week of the Team 2 of Road to the Knockouts, where those cards were packed like crazy and it was supply and like everywhere, and it was almost easy to pack those cards. I haven't packed a single Trailblazers this week. I know a lot of people that haven't seen them at all. The 80 plus upgrades have not been good. So that makes me like these cards because they just feel like they're a little bit more rare. And especially as they've risen throughout the week, that points to good signs of them rising out of packs. So today I think it's going to be a really good day to invest in a few of these Trailblazers cards. The ones that I like the most. Let me take you through. When I look at a promo team to invest in stuff out of packs, this is what I look for. Number one, I look for meta teams or meta players, or really just big clubs, right? Manchester City, Ruben Dias. We have a shortage of Prem center backs in this game. It's VVD, it's Varane. We had an SBC for Diego Carlos that was too expensive, and we have Ledley King, like that's 200K. We need more Prem center back options. Even though this guy has 65 pace, which would be way too slow for a lot of people, he is, if you go down here and look at the number of games played, another way to do this is you can click on the PGP button and it'll pull up another page and show you how many games have been played on this card. Footbin calculates that by the number of cards that are up on the market, the number of games played on those, adds them all together and gets that number. Ruben Dias is the most used player from this promo team right now with 32,000 games. Second place on that list is Di Lorenzo. We'll take a look at his card really quick, 28,000 games. So these are the most two popular cards out of this team, right? Of course, they are one of the cheapest cards in the team as well, which makes them one of the most used because more people can afford them. But also, I like them as some of the best investments, right? That's kind of how I go to gauge an investment potential for out of packs, is how much did their price rise from Sunday to Monday, or from Sunday to Thursday, where we are now. And also, like, there's not a lot of Prem center backs. This Di Lorenzo is like the best right back in the Serie A. I really like both of these guys. I could easily see them rising a decent amount in price even later on today. I think a lot of people want to invest in Ruben Dias and Di Lorenzo. And I think today, either during rewards or marquee matchups, is going to be the time where you have to do it. And whereas if you don't, you're going to start to see these prices rise throughout the weekend. I like Mkhitaryan as well. And guys, I was just taking a look at Koundé. I know that we've got a team two of cards that is coming, and you've got a couple center backs that are in that team, like Marquinhos, Danilo. I think Danilo is going to be super duper cheap, but this Koundé card, guys, is so rare, and you guys know how crazy the Barcelona links are, especially with the women's team players that are on Barca. This card looks absolutely cracked. I know that his playstyle plus maybe isn't as good as his base version, but he does have slide tackle. He still has bruiser. I mean, this card is incredibly, incredibly rare. I like Griezmann as well, being French. I know he doesn't have the finesse shot. He's got Trivella, but he's really rare as well. And, you know, I think some of this promo team has potential to rise. Now, if you see dips today, that is the time to get in on these cards. I also like Matoma. Matoma's been dropping off a lot, but he's in the mini release, so he didn't get supplied a lot from Sunday until today. So watch for more drops on his card today during marquee matchups and during rivals. And if it's a card that you want for your team, I think today is going to be a good day to be buying some of this stuff. And hopefully we'll see some rises during the weekend. Also, I want to point out, make sure I don't have any coins right now, right? Because I'm broke on this stuff, but make sure you stock a Wagner and a Costa, all of the cards that are literally discard right now on this game. Make sure you stock one, put it in the club, and just sit on it and wait till they rise in the next weeks to come, especially with a lot of MLS links coming, even in the league team that is upcoming. I like this buy for sure. Now, for this league team that's upcoming, guys, one of the reasons I feel confident in team one is there's no surprises for what's coming tomorrow. Like, we know it's this team right here. And yes, of course, these stats are predicted, but I think that's going to help the market be a bit more stronger and less panicky and more stable today into tomorrow, because we know what's coming already. This team doesn't look maybe as good as team one, and it kind of puts a lot of the guesswork out of the hesitation out of the market, which is why I think things could continue to go higher today, which is why I'm looking at buying some cards, and you see me have zero coins. That's why I feel pretty confident about the market today, and especially into this weekend. I'm not saying today prices are going to be super low and then they're going to fly. What I'm really saying is today you're going to see a lower point, and then as we go maybe throughout the weekend, you could start to see some prices rising up. Now, my coins right now, as I said, I do have one Harry Kane. I do have a Ter Stegen. I sold one of my Lewandowskis, and I made a really good move yesterday. I'm going to call it a good move. I bought a VVD at 855, guys. Now, I could be losing a lot of coins on this right now. He's very rare, and it was a good move because he actually went up to 950,000 coins right after I bought the card, and he's actually right now getting very rare, and he's about to bounce. He is down a lot. He's 750. It's a very, very rare card. I learned my lesson. I knew I should have sold right away. I didn't, and I'm going to take a bit of an L for it. I'm hoping, though, that I'm not taking a massive L because I'm waiting to sell the card until it rebounds back up, so I've accepted I'm going to lose some coins. But it's okay. We're going to make them back today with the Rivals Rewards time frame. And I still have one Lewandowski that I bought at 390, so that erases the Van Dijk loss at all anyway. Of course, that's not what you want, to make losses and then have another card that was really a big profit for you kind of erase that. But have another Lewandowski in for him. And of course, some of these Road to the Knockout investments still that I'm holding on to. So feeling good about the market today, guys. I think it's an okay day to get out there and get on some buys. Just don't overlook the fodder. But yeah, watch the fodder today during marquee matchups and during the squad or the Rivals Rewards time frame. It's going to be an interesting day today. I hope I get some good rewards. I got to go get one more win of Rivals so that I can get those untradeable rewards upgrades and hopefully finish the Hyunmin Sun SBC for Weekend League this weekend. If you guys enjoyed the video today, if it helped you out at all, drop a thumbs up on it. Drop a comment or a question down below. I'm sure we talked a lot about theory things today. Drop a question down below if you have any of those. I'll be down there answering some of that. If you're new around here as well, drop a subscription to the channel. I appreciate you guys. Thank you for all the love you show on these videos, watching every single day. And I'll see you guys in the Twitch stream today. It's been Nate, TheFutAccountant. Catch you guys there. Peace.